Live on Stream It Sports, Northern Colorado, it's Poudre School District High School Volleyball. This broadcast is brought to you by Schrader Oil. Fuel your day. By Pedersen Toyota, everything cars made easy. And by First Bank. Visit any of our convenient locations in Northern Colorado. And now for the play-by-play, here's Samantha Miller.
Hello from beautiful Fort Collins, Colorado. We are here in the gym of the Fort Collins Lambkins. I am Samantha Miller, joined by Chris Colton on our tech support tonight here on Stream It Sports. We're excited to bring you this volleyball match between the Fort Collins Lambkins and the visiting Boulder Panthers. It should be a fun game tonight. We have two pretty senior teams, a very senior team with the Panthers, all upperclassmen, five seniors, the rest juniors. Fort Collins High School has a comparative four seniors, along with nine upperclassmen, three freshmen, one sophomore, so a little bit more of a mixture there for the Lambkins. But still, we're going to have a very even matchup tonight. Fort Collins Lambkins come in with a record of 4-2, and the Panthers are sitting at 3-2. We will take a quick pause here for the playing of the national anthem coming up shortly, I believe.
Wayne, everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
And we are back here at Fort Collins High School. While we were gone, that national anthem didn't quite get through, a little bit of talking there from head coach. First season here, Jared Rudiger. And now it looks like it is time for the national anthem. So we'll go ahead and give ourselves another break while the national anthem plays, and we'll be right back on Stream It Sports.
Everyone complains about millennials. Nonsense. Millennials, I salute you. You save money like no other generation. You share cars, Wi-Fi passwords, canoes, deodorants. My grandson bought a pair of pants with me. They share pants. Today's his pants day. No baby boomer ever shared a pair of pants with me.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy.
An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore, you're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
Beautiful national anthem there. Nice to see everyone standing at this sporting event. And now we will do the starting lineups for both teams. We'll start with Boulder Panthers. Number one, Leah Fator.
Number two, Kaylee Reagan.
Number three, Nicole Williams.
Number four, Cecily Quinn.
Number five, Harmony Lichko.
Number five, Harmony Lichko.
Number six, Hannah Bagley.
Number six, Hannah Bagley.
Number seven, Cassie Stoffer.
Number eight, Jean Cutter.
Number nine, Emma Chow.
Number Number 10, Kira Krustinger. Number 11, Evie Mathis. And number 14, Claire Boyle. The head coach for the Panthers is Kyle Radigan. And now we will go ahead and meet the Fort Collins Lambkins, the home team tonight, wearing black. You'll notice very similar colors on both sides of the courts. Number one is Tori Whitcomb.
Number two, Audra
Koopman. Number three, Sabrina Vandalist.
Number four, Reagan
Geffro.
Number five, Kayla Elder.
Number five, Kayla Elder.
Number six, Taylor Roar.
Number six, Taylor Roar.
Number seven, Erica Jones.
Number seven, the libero, Erica Jones.
Number eight, Kayla Roar-Cassie.
Number eight, Kayna Roar-Cassie.
Number nine, Sophia Boyer.
Number nine, Sophia Boyer. Number 10, Grayson Vogeser.
Number 11, Hannah Serbusik.
Number 11, Hannah Serbusik.
Number 12, Emma Dern.
Number 12, Emma Dern.
Number 13, Braylee Martvitka.
Number 13, Braylee Martvitka.
Number 16, Trinity Corny.
And number 16, Trinity Corny. That'll round up all of the players, not necessarily the starting lineups, as you can tell. It's interesting to see. I'm very thankful we have the black uniforms going for the Lambkins. The JV match previous to this match, they were in those matching purple uniforms, and you couldn't tell the two teams apart. Fort Collins Lambkins did win that JV match, so we will see if that will hold true for the varsity match coming up. Like we mentioned, the Lambkins are coming in at that 4-2 record, so have one more win under their belt, one more match in general under their belt than the Panthers do, both against very similar level teams. So this could be a five-setter tonight, folks. We'll have to see which team shows up to play. Talking to Coach Rudiger coming into this match, he has a couple sicknesses going on, a couple nagging injuries, and same thing for Radigan. So as long as those players can go ahead and not injure themselves any further, we're going to have a very evenly matched game tonight. You can see those starting lineups out there. Lambkins had seven girls to start. That is not allowed. They're going to clean it up right now. You have Serbowski, the freshman out there for the Lambkins, as well as Koopman. Roar is up in the front row. Vogeser in the back row. Also have the sophomore Jones in at libero, as well as a freshman and Vandalist serving for the Lambkins. Set's going to go outside, tipped over the block, and that'll drop right in front of the freshman. Point Panthers. We'll tally that as a kill for Bagley. Starting over there for the Panthers, you have Bagley. Loco, as they're rotating around, I'll try to read them off to you. We also have Stoffer there. Your libero is Fator. Cutter in the back row. And serving for the Panthers, you have number nine, Chow. Freshman to the senior, and that one goes long. Looking for the touch, and they're not going to get it. An early lead here for the Panthers. 3 points right in a row. Chow will continue to serve to the libero, Jones. Sending it outside, just getting the roll shot over, but it's a good roll shot. That one will drop for the freshman, Serbowski. Zerbowski will rotate back to serve for the Lambkins. That one floating deep, handled nicely by Cutter. Outside high swing, Jones picks it up. Vogaser trying to save that inside set going down the line. And that'll draw the Panthers into the net. Point, Lambkins. Zerbowski continuing to serve. That one drops a little bit shorter. It's going to go backside there, and that's a dominating swing by the junior Bagley. Almost over the block of the Lambkins, straight down in front of those floor defenders. With that kill, Bagley will rotate back to serve. Geffro with the pass. Jones will have to just send it over. Outside set, Geffro picks it up again. Vogaser will take a swing at it, and that one goes long. Point, Panthers. Bagley continuing to serve. Geffro out of system there. Jones just trying to save it, and it's going to hit the basketball hoop. Another point for the Panthers. Panthers doing a nice job back at the service line so far this match, keeping the Lambkins out of system. Geffro, much better pass on that one. Sets out to Vogaser. Down the line, easily picked up and sent over as a free ball, but called into the net by the down ref. Point, Lambkins. Looks like we'll have a little conference here between the down ref and the up ref. Panthers are trying to get the call that the player ran into the net outside the antenna, which is legal, as long as they're not inside the antenna. And yes, they will get that call back at them. We'll have a replay. And Bagley stays back at the service line for the Panthers. Little pause here. Some equipment malfunction. Gonna have to tape up the net there, it looks like. Maybe just something sharp hanging out. Coach Rudiger taping a towel around that bottom part of the net. We'll see if that holds up for the rest of the evening. And with that, we will get back to the first set here in Fort Collins. The junior Bagley continuing to serve for Boulder High School. And an ace for Bagley. She is just eating up that seam between Jones and Geffro. Lots of deep serves. That one lands shorter. Geffro picks it up nicely. Back to Rohr, she just tips it over. Chow going outside to Cutter, another tip picked up. Out to Vogaser, she's a little in front of that ball, but will get the kill. Rotating in for the Lambkins is Rohr Kossi, the junior middle blocker, and Jones will go back to the service line. Another deep serve. Going to have to send a free ball back to the Lambkins. Vogaser sending that ball up. Rohr Kossi takes a swing to the deep corner, and it's a kill. Vandalist doing a nice job, especially as a freshman setter for the Lambkins, trying to handle some a little bit off-kilter passes and keeping a fast offense run right here. And Jones will try to reach back for that one and shanks it. Point Panthers. Both Cutter and Bagley are doing a nice job on the outside for the Panthers. Their height is helping them out tremendously over the top of that block of the Lambkins. Geffro sending a high ball. Vogeser just tipping that one over. Cutter trying to get outside of that, and she does. Vogeser will take another swing, and she'll get the kill. And now we have Sophia Boyer subbing in the front row. Boyer's played a little bit in the middle, a little bit on the right. It looks like with Boyer rotating in, Roark Haase will play this one on the right side of the court. High ball to the backside, and that one just trickles over. Point, Lejoko. Claire Boyle will serve for the Panthers. Deep serve to Vogeser, out of system. Geffer will send it back to Vogeser. She gets a touch. That one might have gone out of bounds. Just a roll shot there from Bagley. And that one will go in the net off the hand of Roark Haase. Passing for the Lambkins, not quite there so far this evening. Lots of out-of-system balls. Can't run that fast offense that Coach Rudiger wants to. Deep ball. Geffro passing off the net again. Vogeser just giving that roll shot. Puts him out of system. Bagley tipping over again. Jones up to Roar. A tip from Boyer. Sending that ball outside to Cutter. And she'll get the kill. Roar can't quite handle that one. Boyle will continue serving for the Panthers, who are starting to pull away in this first set. Ball out to Vogeser. She's on top of that one, but it's dug up. And a great tip by number 9, Emma Chow. She'll get the kill. And with that, Coach Rudiger is over the long run from the Panthers. He'll call a timeout. Score here in Fort Collins, Colorado, is 12-5 in the first set. Panthers leading the Lambkins. We'll be right back on Stream It Sports.
Wayne, everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
And we are back here in the gym of the Fort Collins Lambkins in beautiful Fort Collins, Colorado. A little bit of a chilly night here. Luckily, we are inside. Been a rainy day up north in Colorado. Right now, we have the Boulder Panthers leading the Fort Collins Lambkins 12-5 here in the first set. A little sluggish, the Lambkins are not passing their best, trying to get some kind of offense running, and that will not be it. Roark Haase sending it deep. With that, we'll have a sub. Serbowski will come right back in for Geffro. Try to get a little bit different look back there in the passing lanes. And get a nice pass here for Roar to run her offense. Jones sends it up to Roar. Quickly to Boyer. Boyer sends it to deep corner, but handled by Fator. That one goes deep from Cutter. Vogeser takes a swing, and she'll bust through the block. Vogeser always has some power. Not one of the highest hitters, but has a heavy arm for the Lambkins. She will now be back at the service line for Fort Collins. And that one will bounce off the antenna out of bounds. Nothing seems to be rolling in the direction of Fort Collins tonight. Can't get any kind of run going. Serving, serve, receive, or really attacking up there at the net. Panthers will serve, and that one goes deep. Two service errors in a row. Cutter the one sending that ball long. Roar Cossie will sub out, and Tori Whitcomb will come in to serve. Whitcomb going to send over a jump floater. That one drops short, and she'll get the ace. Just dropping in front of Claire Boyle on that serve. Lots of movement on those jump float serves. It's fun to watch when players can execute them accurately. Another one dropping, and she'll get another ace. Tori Whitcomb, first time on the court, and she gets two aces in a row. And with that, Coach Kyle Radigan will decide to take a timeout for his Panthers. Panthers still leading 14-9 here in the first set. We'll be right back on Stream It Sports.
Everyone complains about millennials. Nonsense. Millennials, I salute you. You save money like no other generation. You share cars, Wi-Fi passwords, canoes, deodorants. My grandson bought a pair of pants with me. They share pants. Today's his pants day. No baby boomer ever shared a pair of pants with me.
Welcome back here on Stream It Sports. We're bringing you the high school volley match between Fort Collins Lambkins and the Boulder Panthers. Right now the Panthers are leading 14-9. Tori Whitcomb serving the third ball, two aces in a row before this. That one handled by the Panthers, now out of system, but sent over a free ball. And a dump from the setter. Emma Chow gets another kill. Jones will come in for Whitcomb on the side of the Panthers. Or, excuse me, the Lambkins. Panthers will be serving here. Nicole Williams back at that service line. Bogusser to Roar. Roar to Koopman, and that one's in the net. Williams continuing to serve. Panthers up seven. Now a little deeper into that first set. Bogusser, another nice pass. Koopman that time gets through the block. Lots of movement at the net, but no call. High swing there from the freshman, and Zerbowski will get the kill. Vandalis rotating in for the Lambkins as Boyer takes a seat. Vandalis will serve. That's a short one dropping in front of the libero, but it's kept alive, and that one will die. Nice touch there from Fator. Chow making a diving save, but just no one left to get it over the net. Vandalis continues back at the service line. Another jump float there. Dropping. Saved again by Chow. Bogusser picks it up. And on that one, Vandalis will be called in the net. Point Panthers. Lodgeco will come back into the game as Boyle takes the seat. Chow serving for the Panthers. Deep serve to Jones. Jones handles it. Vandalis will send it out to Roar, and that one goes wide. Not finding much of a connection. Like I mentioned, that freshman doing a nice job. Vandalis is putting up good balls, but she is a freshman. They haven't quite found that connection early in the season yet, but I'm sure Coach Rudiger will be focusing on that going into the later parts of the season. And there's a little bit of a connection. Kill from Koopman. Serbowski to serve. That one dropping out of system, and that'll be an ace for the Lambkins. Freshman really doing a nice job for the Lambkins. Something we cannot say about the Panthers, considering they have no underclassmen. But all those juniors and seniors for the Panthers doing a nice job. That is one of them. Bagley drops over. And Bagley will get the block along with Stauffer. Lots of height on the right side of your screen. Vogeser just not quite competing up at that height tonight. She is one of those players that's a little sick, so we'll have to make sure she can make it through the whole match. Jones up to Vanilis. Vogeser taking another swing to the cross court. Fator handles it. That's going to go outside to Cutter, and she will get the kill. Another timeout called by Coach Rudiger. That's his second of the set. He is trailing by 7, 20-13. Once the team hits 20, you know they're getting close to the end there. We'll be back to bring you the end of this first set on Stream It Sports.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy.
An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore. You're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
Welcome back to the end of the first set here at Fort Collins High School. We have the Fort Collins Lambkins and the Boulder Panthers. Boulder right now commanding this set. They are up 20-13. Boulder will continue to serve right now. Deep ball. Geffro handles that one nicely. Roar tipping over the block. Easy ball for Fator. Another tip from the Panthers. That one Stauffer, and she'll get the kill. Rudiger trying to mix it up again. This time, Dern will sub in for Roar. Dern making her first appearance of the set. She will be playing on the right side. Bagley with the serve. Bogeser takes a swing, and that one goes deep. Another mix-up from Rudiger. Serbowski coming back in for Geffro. Misconnect there. Koopman can't reach it. Vogeser just has to send a free ball. Another tip from Stauffer that's going to drop. You can tell the seniority of this Panthers team. They've played together for a long time, all juniors and seniors. Much higher level of connecting there on their offense than you see on the left side of your screen. A mix up here, jump top spin. Nice pass from Jones. Vogeser with a big swing. Great up by Bagley. Bagley taking a swing out of the back row. Up from Serbowski. Swing from Dern. We're going to have another swing from Bagley here in the back row, and Jones can't handle it. Bagley doing an outstanding job for the Panthers, getting kills front row, back row, aggressive serving, doing a very nice job. She will continue to serve. Looks like we're going to see another jump top. And that one sails long. You can tell that's not her normal serve. Coach Radigan said, okay, we're up by 11 points. You can mix this guy in. Libero, Erica Jones, serving for the Lambkins. Set point, Panthers. Sent over, Jones picks it up. Vogeser will take a swing. Picked up by Bagley. Chow going outside to Cutter. off the top of the block. Jones sending it out to Dern. And that one goes long. With that, we have the Panthers taking the first set 25-14. Commanding fashion here in Fort Collins, Colorado. Boulder taking control. We'll be right back to bring you the second set here on Stream It Sports after this.
Wayne, everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
Everyone complains about millennials. Nonsense. Millennials, I salute you. You save money like no other generation. You share cars, Wi-Fi passwords, canoes, deodorants. My grandson bought a pair of pants with me. They share pants. Today's his pants day. No baby boomer ever shared a pair of pants with me.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy. An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore, you're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
And we are back here at Fort Collins High School, home of the Lambkins, as they take on the visiting Boulder Panthers. The visitors doing a nice job in the first set, winning 25-14. That 11-point spread gained slowly in the first half of that set, and then some long runs gone at the end. Bagley serving back that service line, which seemed like forever. Making it easy for the Panthers to run away with that set. We'll have to see if Coach Rudiger makes any big change-ups. It looks like he has switched out his libero for the time being. Erica Jones taking a seat for now. Kayla Elder now donning the libero jersey for the Lambkins. Chow will start serving right at that new libero. Sent out to Vogeser, and she busts through the block. And with that, Vanilis will rotate out, and Boyer will be back on the court. Rohr serving for the Lambkins. Chow. Outside to Lujoko, and that one's blocked. Big block over there on the outside with Rorikasi and Boyer. Chow sending it to the backside, and Bagley will hit in the net. Deja vu from the last set, but the other way around, and with that, Kyle Radigan will call a timeout for his Panthers. Doesn't like the start of the second set. We will be right back after this break.
Wayne, everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
Back here with the Lambkins and the Panthers. Nice little change up there, bringing Bagley around in the front, running a two. With that swing, the Panthers will side out. Bagley back at the service line. Nice pass by Elder, and Vogeser will get another kill. A different Grace than Vogeser we're seeing so far in this set. She's playing to her strengths, not trying to hit over that tall block on the other side of the net. Vogeser serving. And that one goes long. I may have jinxed her a little bit there. Fator serving for the Panthers. Overpass and dominated by Williams. Serbowski only seeing some time in the back row there, sharing some of that time with Geffro, so not getting a ton of reps passing. Fator serving again. Much better pass on that one. Going backside to Rorikasi. Picked up nicely by Bagley. And that one goes out of bounds off the hands of Lojoko. Elder will now serve for the Lambkins. Fator up to Chow. Chow sounds it out to Cutter. Blocked but picked up nicely by Bagley. Another swing from Cutter. Vogeser barely getting there as Roar, and she'll send it out of bounds. Rudiger not okay with that. Wants Taylor Roar to be able to run that ball down. Little discussion here between the down ref and the scorer's table. Lojko ready to take his seat. Boyle about to sub in to serve. This could be a discussion either about the rotation of the girls, if they're in the right rotation, if the score is correct. Everything looks good. Down ref will give it back to the up ref. And after that quick little pause, Boyle is ready to serve. Boyle to Vogeser. Boyer keeps it alive. A swing from Elder. Sends that ball back to Bagley. A short ball. Koopman tries to handle it. Boyer tries to save it. Koopman sends it over. Chow dumps it. Picked up. Still alive. Little bit of a scramble here. Elder gets too excited and sends that ball out of bounds. Boyer continuing to serve. We're now all tied up here in the second set. Nice float. Zerbowski out of system. Roar saves it. Zerbowski will send it over. Chow tips it, and it's tipped right back at her by Koopman. Point Lambkins. Vandalis rotates in as Boyer takes a seat on the bench. Fanless will serve. Nice dropping serve there. Chowda Williams, free ball from Vogeser. Chowda Williams yet again. That one's a deep corner. Vogeser gets it up. Outside of the freshman, up from Boyle. Another ball sent over, just dropping in front of the floor defense for the Lambkins. Very clever setting we've seen tonight from Chow. She's a creative player. She knows when to dump it with one hand, two hands, who to set, in which situations. Again, what you would expect from a senior. Vogeser sending the free ball. Fator to Chow. Chow gives it to Williams again. Cut shot handled by Vanliss. Freshman taking another swing, and that's a kill for Zerbowski. Zerbowski will serve now. Lambkins up by one. Just a dropping ball, and she'll get the ace. Boyle shakes her head. She says, serve me again. And Zerbowski does. Boyle, much better pass on that one. Chow back to Williams. Roar will go out to Vogeser. Tip over the block. And that one will fall. Clever changeup. Boyle can't quite drop down and get to it. Nice run we have going here for the Lambkins. 4 points now. Zerbowski will continue to put on the pressure. And that one's just long. Point Panthers. Stauffer coming into the front row for the Panthers. Williams at the service line. Williams sends out one deep, but it stays in. Saved by Vanliss. Vogeser with a high swing. Easy pass, a joust, and it's won by Koopman. Williams trying to play some floor defense back there for the Panthers, just couldn't quite keep it on their side. Jones, we mentioned, is not the libero this set, but she is still in the game. Back to serve for the Lambkins. Sends that one deep. Boyle to Chow. Chow gives that one to Bagley, and she'll get the tool off the block. Roar, Cassie, and Roar up there just can't quite keep it in the court. Lodgeco back in the game for the Panthers. Boyle will take a break. Chow serving. Nice deep serve. Jones with the pass to Vanliss. Vanliss to Rokossi, and that one's out. Student section coming alive here a little bit at Fort Collins. They don't like that call. Chow drops that one short. Pass by Zerbowski. Vogeser with the swing, and that one is in. Boyer subs in for Vanliss. Roar at the service line. Short serve dropping in front of Bagley. Bagley will swing off of it. Jones to Roar. Boyer through the block. Chow passing up to Bagley. Just a roll shot there from Cutter. Yet it will score. Well placed there by Lodgeco. Excuse me. Bagley with the serve, that one just falling. Nice pass from Jones. Vogeser with the swing and the kill. Much more terminal player this match. And it's very interesting to see Jones back there not wearing the libero jersey, but playing almost more aggressive defense than she did when she was. Lambkins lead by two here. Vogeser with the serve, Cutter to Chow. Chow back to Cutter. Strong cut shot picked up. Vogeser, the roll shot from the back row. Bagley to Chow, just trying to send it over there. Stouffer, she'll get the Lambkins out of system. Free ball. Chow giving the ball back to Lodgeco. Jones to Rorikasi, and she'll get the kill. Nice swing down the line. That's a difficult angle where that ball's coming from. She still hit it at a high point. The junior doing a nice job for the Lambkins. Bogusser continuing to serve. Cutter with the off pass. She'll have to come in and just roll shot that one over. Jones to Roar. Roar back to Rorikasi again in the changeup. Little bit of a tip there versus her hard-driven swing on the last ball, and she'll get the kill. Bogusser continuing her streak, now up by four. 14-10 here in the second set at Fort Collins High School. And Bogusser gets the ace off the platform of Fator. That's enough for Radigan. He'll call a timeout for the Panthers. We're at 15-10 here in the second set. Panthers took the first 25-14, and now Lambkins are up in the second. We'll be right back on Stream It Sports.
Everyone complains about millennials. Nonsense. Millennials, I salute you. You save money like no other generation. You share cars, Wi-Fi passwords, canoes, deodorants. My grandson bought a pair of pants with me. They share pants. Today's his pants day. No baby boomer ever shared a pair of pants with me.
We are back here in Northern Colorado bringing you the second set in the match between the Boulder Panthers and the Fort Collins Lambkins. Boulder took away that first set from the Lambkins. Lambkins now leading 15-10 in the second. Vogeser serving. Tight ball. Chow handles it easily, but sent out of bounds by Stauffer. Now a five-point run for Vogeser back there at the service line. Another deep ball from Vogeser, and that one will go just wide. Panthers thinking they need to get something going here as they trail 11-16. Fator back to serve. That one goes deep. Jones passes up to Rohr. She'll go out to Zabrowski. Just a tip out of system. Bagley swings. Another great up, but out of system. Bogusser with a swing. Back over there, and Williams will have to tip it in. It's not going to clear the tape. Koopman, little confusion there. Has to sub back in for Jones. Can't just switch in, considering she's not in that different color jersey. Elder, the libero, back to serve for the Lambkins. To Fator, Chow will save it, and Bagley just sends it over with a free ball. Elder, outside is Zerbowski, and she'll get the kill. Serve there, nice pass. Williams to the deep corner, and Bogusser can't handle it. Point Panthers. Boyle coming in to serve. Krustinger taking a seat. Bogusser to Roar. Back to Boyer, and she tries to tip it over and can't quite get there. A little bit of disconnect. Boyer trying to stay in front on some balls and then rotating behind. Roar just not finding her yet. Boyle continues serving. Bogusser to Roar. She'll save it. Koopman with a swing. A joust, and that one's won by Chow. Panthers working on that comeback, within four now. Score is 18-14 here in the second set. Little bit of an overpass there. Chow just dinks it back over. And it'll still drop in front of the Lambkins. Rudiger taking his time out here in the second. We'll be right back on Stream of Sports.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy.
An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore, you're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
And we are back here at the second set between Fort Collins Lambkins and the Boulder Panthers here in Fort Collins, Colorado. Panthers trying to make a comeback here, and they are being successful. Now bringing that score within 2 points when they trailed by as much as seven. Vandalis will rotate in for Boyer now. Rudiger mixing it up with a different setter. He'll have Vandalis set. Koopman and Zerbowski swinging. And Zerbowski will put that one in the tape. Freshman trying not to crack too much under the pressure. Score 17-18. Lambkins still winning, but only by one at this point. Boyle continuing her service streak. Zerbowski up to Vandalis. Zerbowski will take a swing. Handled by Bagley. Chow out to Cutter. Cutter with the high swing. Kept alive. Up at the net. That's a tight one. Chow tips it over. And the Panthers will get the point. A lift. Called against the Lambkins. Rudiger isn't too happy about it, but he can't be too happy about much right now. Lambkins throwing away quite the lead, all tied up now in the second set. Elder, Vandalis, Bogusser with the swing and the kill. The senior and Grayson Bogusser wants to fight a little bit here. I'm sure her setters are looking for her. Want to take a little bit of pressure off the freshman. Vandalis to the freshman on, or to the libero on the other side of the net. Bogusser will take another swing. That one out of system. Roll shot from Cutter. Elder to Vandalis. High swing from Zerbowski. She'll take another swing and get the kill as well as draw the Panthers into the net. Point Lambkins. They're now back up by two, 20-18. Vandalis continuing to serve. Bagley just barely handling that one. Cutter standing down ball over the net. Koopman, Vandalis. Swing there from Rohr, and that one goes long. Panthers will serve, trailing by one in the second set. Elder out of system. Great hustle. But Vogeser can't quite get it over the net. The freshman doing everything she can to save that one. Vandalis is laying out on the floor by the bench. After that ball, Coach Rudiger will take his second timeout of the second set. All tied up at 20. We'll be right back on Stream of Sports.
Wayne, everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
Back here for the second set at Fort Collins High School. High school volleyball match between the Boulder Panthers and the Fort Collins Lambkins. Panthers have all the momentum on their side right now. Came back from a 6-point deficit, all tied up. And they won the first set. A tip from Moore, picked up by Chow. Fator will send it to Bagley, and Bagley puts that one in the net. Vogelser back in the front row now. Serbowski serving for the Lambkins. That ball passed tight to the net. Koopman will get the roof. Looked like she was a little over the net from our vantage point, but whatever that up ref says goes. Subbing in Tori Whitcomb, who you'll remember got two aces in a row the last time she came off the bench. Zerbowski will take a seat. Whitcomb drops that one in. Chow will send it out to Bagley. Over the block, but out of bounds. Whitcomb serving again for the Lambkins. 2 points away from taking the set. And she'll get an ace. Both Cutter and Fator look at each other. Excuse me, Boyle and Fator look at each other. Don't want to be the one passing that serve. Set point here for Whitcomb. Boyle to Chow to Bagley, and she'll get over and through the block. Little bit of both. Trying to keep the Panthers in this second set. They got to go on a little bit of a run here. Williams will try to be the one to start that run off back at the service line. And she'll get an ace. Miscommunication there between Elder and Zerbowski. Williams serving again. Deep ball Zerbowski, and she can't handle it. Williams trying to get at least one more, keep them in this set. Whitcomb will sub back in for Zerbowski. Williams dropping that serve a little shorter to Elder. Vanlis out to Vogelser. She's off balance, kept alive. Bagley will take a swing. Looks like there was a touch on the block. Bagley will go at it again. Tips over the block. Picked up by Vogelser. Free ball from Elder. Chow out to Bagley again. And that ball lands inbounds off the block. The Lambkins will take the second set here at Fort Collins High School. We are now at 1-1. Little bit closer set that time. If you'll remember, that first set was taken by the Panthers 25-14. The second set taken by the Lambkins 25-23. When we get back, we will bring you the third set here in Northern Colorado on Stream It Sports.
Everyone complains about millennials. Nonsense. Millennials, I salute you. You save money like no other generation. You share cars, Wi-Fi passwords, canoes, deodorants. My grandson bought a pair of pants with me. They share pants. Today's his pants day. No baby boomer ever shared a pair of pants with me.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy. An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore, you're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Fort Collins, Colorado. We're at Fort Collins High School, home of the Lambkins. Into the third set now this evening. We are tied 1-1 as far as sets go. Panthers took that first one, and Lambkins came back and won the second set. The Lambkins will start off serving. Roar back at the service line. Libero staying at Elder. Chow will send this ball out, and Bagley will get the kill. Bagley, one of those players that has been on fire for the Panthers tonight. Made a couple errors towards the end of that second set that I'm sure Coach Radigan wasn't too happy about, but otherwise just playing outstanding. Another player that's been doing a nice job, Zerbowski, gets the tool off the block. I think everyone on the bench on that ball was afraid that Elder was going to play the out-of-bounds ball. Zerbowski to Bagley. Chow will send it back to Bagley, and Bagley will get through the block. After the kill, Bagley will get back to that service line to serve. That deep jump float, and she'll get the ace off Zerbowski. Bagley serving once again. Zerbowski again to Roar. Vogeser will take a swing, and she'll get a kill. Jones rotating in for Roar Cossie to serve. Koopman entering up at the front row for the Lambkins. Jones with the deep serve to Bagley. Bagley to Chow. Chow will send it out to Cutter, and Cutter will get the kill down the line. Just tooling off the hands of Van Liss on that one. Roar couldn't adjust in time. Fator serving. Ball out to Vogeser, picked up by Bagley. And that point will go to the Lambkins, double called against the Panthers. Van Liss serving for the Lambkins. That one dropping to Fator. Chow will give it to Williams, picked up by Jones. And Koopman sends the free ball to the Panthers. Chow to Williams again, picked up by Van Liss. This time Chow's going to Cutter, and Cutter gets over the block and gets the kill. Elder coming in for Zerbowski. Claire Boyle serving for the Panthers. Elder to Van Liss, sending it back. No one's there. Roar will send a free ball. Chow with the dump. Jones picks it up. Van Liss to Roar, picked up by Fator. Tipped over by Williams, and she'll get the kill. The defense has improved as this match has gone on. Both sides of the court doing an outstanding job picking up balls that they weren't in that first set. Koopman with the swing and the kill. Coach Rudiger asking for the lineup check. As most of you know at home, each coach gets only 2 timeouts per set, but can ask for a lineup check as many times as they want. Sometimes coaches will use it as a tactic to slow down the game a little bit. Or sometimes they really don't know who their next server is. Fogeser is that next server for the Lambkins. That one drops on Bagley out of system. And a double call against Chow. That's two doubles in this set against Chow, who otherwise has been playing a very clean match for the Panthers. Vogeser serving again for the Lambkins. That one goes deep and out of bounds. Vogeser not quite able to find her serving groove yet. If you notice, the first couple sets she was standing on the ground. That last time back of the line, she was doing a jump float. Neither one being very consistent tonight. Zerbowski taking a swing, and that one's out of bounds. With Zerbowski being such a young player, it takes some time for her to get in her rhythm, I'm sure. Towards the end of this season, she'll be a much different player than she is now. That one sails long off the hand of Cutter. Jones rotating out as Rorikasi comes in. Elder will serve for the Lambkins. That one dropping. Chowelson all the way to the outside. Tipped over by Bagley, and it drops. We haven't seen a tremendous amount of tips from Bagley tonight, but when she mixes them in, she does a nice job of placing them right in front of that floor defender. Otherwise, she's just taking big swings. Dying serve there. Williams with the ace. Williams serving again for the Panthers. That one floating a little bit deeper. Van Liss will send that one outside. Chow going outside to her hitter, and that one will be a tool. Bagley with the kill. Miscommunication there from the line judge. That ball's just out of bounds, no touch. Williams will serve. Elder to Van Liss. Outside is Zerbowski off the top of the block. Out of system. Chow's going to go outside. Bagley gets that one to drop. Point, Panthers. Panthers now taking a little bit of a quiet run, and they are up by 6. 12-6 here in the third. Panthers lead. We will bring you the rest of set number 3 when we get back on Stream It Sports.
Everyone complains about millennials. Nonsense. Millennials, I salute you. You save money like no other generation. You share cars, Wi-Fi passwords, canoes, deodorants. My grandson bought a pair of pants with me. They share pants. Today's his pants day. No baby boomer ever shared a pair of pants with me.
And we are back to Fort Collins High School here in Northern Colorado. Right now, the Lambkins are trailing the Panthers 12-6 in the third set. The Lambkins and Panthers split the first two sets 1-1. And that is the defense we have been talking about that is just improving as the match goes on. Very scrappy on both sides. That one just going out of bounds. Zerbowski. Hard angle there, but just got to keep that one in play. Williams continues to serve. That one going a little bit long off the hand of Williams. And with that, the Lambkins will take control back at the service line. Roar serving. Chow's going to do a 2 there. A little bit of a change up to Bagley. Picked up by the Lambkins. And Zerbowski sending that one down the line. Doing a nice job of bouncing back after an error, which is what you always like to see out of a freshman. Roar continues to serve. Overpass. Roar will handle it. Van Liss up to Roar Cossie. Tipped over. Picked up by the Panthers. And a free ball sent over by Fator. Out to Serbowski. And that one just drops over. A little bit of a misconnection on her hand. But she's okay with it. A kill's a kill. Lambkins now within four of the Panthers. Out of system. Free ball going to be sent over by Chow. Elder to Roar. Back to Roar Cossie. And that one's just out of bounds down the line. She was salivating at that set. Couldn't quite get on top of it. Krustinger is now in for the Panthers. Chow serving. Elder barely picks it up. Roar with a running save, and Bogusser sends over the free ball. Chow out to Bagley, and that one's in the net. Geffro subbing in to serve for the Lambkins as Zerbowski takes a seat. Sending that one deep, but it stays in. Fator gets ace, and Chow can't quite get there. Geffro serving again for the Lambkins. And again, off the platform of Fator. With that, Coach Kyle Radigan will call a timeout here in the third set. Lambkins have managed to bring it back within 2 points, sitting at 12-14. We'll be right back here in the third set at Fort Collins High School.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy.
An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore, you're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
Welcome back to Fort Collins High School. The Lambkins trying to continue this run in the third set. Geffro back at the service line, getting the Panthers out of system. Bagley will tip that ball over. Geffro picks it up. Elder out to Vogaser, and just a free ball over there. Cutter to Chow. She'll send it up in the middle. And another free ball coming over the net from Fort Collins. Outside to Bagley. Deep ball handled by Elder. Roar out to Bogusser, off the block, and lands in. Much higher swing from Bogusser there than we've seen so far this evening. Fort Collins with the momentum now, bringing it within one. Geffer at the service line, sending it deep. Fator saved up by Cutter, and just a roll shot sent over by Krustinger. Bogusser saves it. Fator to Bagley. Bagley off the top of the block, and she'll get the kill. Bagley now back at the service line for the Panthers. Elder to Roar. Out to Vogaser. And that one just barely out. Bagley continues to serve for Boulder High School. Geffro to Roar, out to Bogusser again. That one Bagley handles, and it's an overpass. Geffro to Roar, again to Bogusser, mixes it up with the tip, and she scores. the senior, doing her best to lead the team to victory. Another senior rotating up front, Audra Koopman. Got a senior front row here for the Lambkins. But the ace comes from a sophomore, Erica Jones, back at the service line. Another dropping serve, that one. Nice pass from Cutter. And a tip will get the kill. Stauffer making a smart play there. Fator at the service line for the Panthers. Vogeser to Rohr. Rohr will send it back to Vogeser. Going deep. Bagley handles it to Chow. Cutter down the line. Touched. Still a scramble. And Geffro makes a great play but can't quite save it off the rafters. Another point for the Panthers. Fator serving Geffro to Rohr. Rohr out to Vogeser. That one she'll send down the line and get a kill. Chow in a great spot but a little too much heat on that ball. Vanliss back to serve for the Lambkins. The freshman will have to make a little bit of a run here to get the Lambkins back in, and that's a great start. An ace for the freshman setter. Vanliss sends out one deep, stays in. Fator to Chow, back to Bagley. Picked up by Vanliss. Koopman will send it over to Rohr. Rohr gets blocked, but the ball's kept alive. And that's out of bounds off the antenna. Coach Radigan's trying to ask for four contacts, but it bounced a couple times off heads, but was sent over in three. Chow trying to debate it too. Looks like there's enough pushback from the Panthers that the down ref will have a little bit of a discussion with the up ref. Even with the line judges, probably not really those line judges' call. They do not have the best vantage point. It's going to have to be between the up ref and the down ref, but it always helps to have more voices in on the conversation. Lots of heads shaking down there. I don't think anyone wants to make this call. We're a ways up here, but from our point of view, it looked like only three contacts, and that is what it will stay. Point goes to the Lambkins after a little bit of a debate there, and we are all tied up in the third set. We do not have instant replay at this level. No challenge is allowed. That is a new rule this year at the collegiate level, as you may have seen in the Olympics if you watched any of the Olympic volleyball. Each coach gets two challenges, and they actually do have instant replay. Freshman continues to serve. Bagley with the overpass. Vogeser sends it over. Free ball will come back at the Lambkins. Koopman to Vogeser. It's a tight ball, and she'll get it over. Chow sending it back to Bagley, and it's in the net. Lambkins continuing this nice streak here towards the end of the third set. They are now in the lead for the first time the entire set, I believe. Another strong serve. Vanliss not letting off. Chow wants to take control, but Jones is there. Vanliss back to Rohr. High swing. Chow rolls up her platform. Bagley's there. Chow will free ball it. Geffro up to Vanliss. Rohr with the high swing. Bagley gets a touch on it. We got Faro Everyone's getting a little bit of touch on this ball. Bogus there with the swing. Bagley right there. Cutter taking a hack at it. Van Liss up. Roar out to Vogaser. Another strong swing, and that one's not handled. Point Lambkins. Great rally on both sides of your screen right there. But not good enough for Radigan. He wants to call another timeout as the Lambkins are now up by two in the third. We will be right back on Stream It Sports. Exciting third set here in Fort Collins, Colorado. Lambkins making a comeback. Freshman back at the service line. Williams with the swing, and that one goes just long. Great composure being shown by Sabrina Vandalis. Back at the service line, going on a run for the Lambkins. Another short serve, and she'll get an ace. Lambkins now up by four when they trailed by as many as six earlier in this set. Krestinger will take a seat. Lodgeco rotating back in. Another ace for the freshman. Panthers starting to crumble a little bit here under the pressure. 2 points now from winning this set. The Lambkins trying to finish it out. Another short serve, one of the greatest short serves I've seen in a long time. And again, the Panthers cannot handle it. Set point here for Van Liss and the Lambkins. I will remind you that the Panthers have taken a set, so even though we're in the third, we will be going to a fourth. Block from Koopman, and the Lambkins will take the third set here at Fort Collins High School. First set, 25-14, goes to the Panthers. Next two sets go to the Lambkins, 25-23 and 25-18. Going into the fourth set could be the final one if the Lambkins can close it out. Otherwise, if the Panthers take it, we will be going to five. Either way, lots of good volleyball here in Fort Collins tonight, and we'll be right back to bring you the rest on Stream It Sports. welcome back to Fort Collins High School with Stream It Sports. We want to thank our banner sponsor, GoJo Sports. GoJo Sports has been providing team sporting needs since 1974. Screen printing, embroidery, letter jackets, and more. Your local place to get high school gear. Check out their new location at 1437 Riverside, just down from the Colorado Inn on the south side of the street. Let our sponsors know how much you appreciate them helping us bring you live high school volleyball action. Other sponsors that we have, as you've noticed tonight, I'm sure, are Schrader Oil, Pedersen Toyota, First Bank, and Next Broadcast. We appreciate all of our sponsors for all of their help in letting us bring you these live high school games, especially exciting ones like we have tonight. We have Fort Collins High School leading right now against Boulder High School, 2-1. They have been very close sets besides the first, which the Panthers ran away with a little bit. Lambkins have fought back in these next two sets, and we are now in the fourth here. The Panthers will start serving. We have Emma Chow back at the service line, a senior setter for the Panthers who has been doing a tremendous job tonight, running a great offense, hustling all over the court. Even out of system passes, she's getting there. A little transversely, on the opposite side of the court, we have a freshman setter, Sabrina Vanless, who's also been doing an outstanding job, both at the service line setting and defensively. For a freshman, she's shown tremendous composure, which is fun to see. It's going to be exciting to watch her through the rest of her career here as a Lambkin. Got a lot of time left and is going to develop into even a more impressive player, I'm sure. Liberos have rotated in. Those middles have taken their seats. And it's time to get the fourth set going. Bogusser to Rohr. Rohr will send that one up to Zerbowski. But with the kill is on the other side of the net. Bagley drops it just outside of Bogusser's reach. Chow back at the service line. That one dropping. Kept alive, Rohr to Zerbowski. Chow to Bagley. Bogusser handles that one, but it's over. Kept alive here. Oh my goodness, there we go. A little bit of miscommunication, sent over. And it looks like that one lands in. Stauffer will get the kill. Chow continuing to serve. Elder to Rohr. Rohr will win the joust. Looks like Bagley forgot she was in the front row, which is something that is easy to run into. Coach Rudiger is running a 6-2 offense, both with Rohr and Vanless. But every once in a while, he'll leave his setter in the front row. Typically, with that 6-2, you'll see the setter in the back row. Looks like Bagley just lost track a little bit on that one. Rohr serving. Little bit of a shank there from Cutter, and we can't bring it back. Point will go to the Lambkins, all tied up early on here in the fourth set. Drop in a little bit of a short serve there. Chow to Stauffer. Now we're going outside to Zerbowski. But the Panthers are called in the net. Looks like Stauffer got a little bit too tight there. Point Lambkins. Rohr will continue to serve for Fort Collins High School. Chow saves that one. Bagley will take a high swing, just a tip. And that one is a tool. Zerbowski off the block. Rohr dropping in another short serve. Bagley to Chow. Chow just sends it over. Easy ball for Rohr. Bogusser back to Zerbowski. Picked up by Stauffer. Tipped through there. Looks like Lodgeko stayed out of the net. Another pickup from Cutter. Bagley with the high swing, but she's blocked. Boyer very active at the net, both with the block and then right back off the ground, sending that one back. Rohr continuing her service streak. Free ball sent back over to the Lambkins. Nice up by Vogeser. Rohr back to Rohr Kasi, and she'll keep that ball in play. Point Lambkins. Rohr still back there at the service line. Overpass from the Panthers. Vogeser up to Zerbowski in that one. Trying to get the roll shot in, but just dribbles into the net. Bagley will head back to the service line for the Panthers. Vogeser can't quite handle that one. Ace Bagley. Another serve from the Panthers. Vogeser, better pass on that one. Rohr to Boyer, and that one's out of bounds. Bagley continuing her run for the Panthers. Vogeser to Rohr. Out to Zerbowski. Overpass from the Panthers. Another overpass. Getting a little bit sloppy in here. We'll get a swing from Cutter, and she'll get the kill off the block. Bagley getting another jump serve in back at the line. Lambkins called out of rotation. Could potentially be because the setter, Taylor Rohr, is leaving a little too early. Bagley with another serve. Vogeser to Rohr. Rohr Kasi with the kill. Zerbowski rotating out. Geffro back at the service line. If you'll remember, Geffro is the one who went on the long run at the end of the third set to get the Lambkins back in and eventually win that set. Dropping to Fator. Block up at the net, but kept alive by the Panthers. Geffro to Vogeser. And a couple balls into the net. Lambkins will get the point. Lambkins now with the lead, 8-7 here at the beginning of the fourth. Geffro sending that one deep. Cutter up to Chow. Cutter will take the swing, and she'll get over the block. Great deep corner shot from Cutter, the senior outside hitter. Fator back to serve. Elder to Rohr. Vogeser just tipping it over. Chow to Fator. Cutter with the high swing, and she'll get through the block. Fator still at the service line for the Panthers. Elder to Rohr, out to Vogeser. High swing off the block, and she'll get the kill. Koopman back on the court for the Lambkins, as well as Jones, who will be back serving. Bagley to Chow. Chow's going to send it out to Cutter. A tip not quite clear in the block. Block for the seniors, Koopman and Boyer. Jones continuing to serve. And that one just snags the tape. Doesn't quite clear the net. Point, Panthers. Boyle serving for the Panthers. That one drops to Geffro. Roar out to Vogeser. And Bagley gets it up. Saved by Boyle. Free ball sent over to the Lambkins. Koopman saved again. Very scrappy play, and they can't keep that one alive. Great heads up on both sides of the court. Again, balls that were dropping in that first set are not dropping in the fourth. The freshman setter, Vanless, will serve for the Lambkins. Nice short serve. And Williams spikes that one to the ground. Obviously not intentionally. Another server that went for a nice run at the end of the last set. Overpass. Barely saved by the Lambkins. Tipped over. And again, kept alive. Free ball from the Lambkins. Chow sends it outside to Cutter. And Cutter hits that one out of bounds. Not quite sure what they're pointing at. The line judge did call that ball out of bounds. The line judges have no say about any calls that go on at the net or anything besides in, out, or touch. That ball was very clearly out of bounds, so it would have had to be another ball. Coach Rudiger is not happy. The up ref did not give a signal, so I'm not sure exactly what the call was. The only signal we saw was that the point is being awarded to the Panthers. There was no reasoning given. Rudiger is not giving up. He may be giving up, but he's not making the down ref feel happy about it. Jones to Vanilis. Low set to Koopman, but she gets it over. Free ball will be sent back to the Lambkins. Jones to Vanilis. Out to Vogeser. Nice pickup there from Cutter. Back and forth here from both these teams, and the tip will drop. Late call on the lift there. Vogeser was already done. Sub coming in. Zerbowski back on the floor as Vogeser goes back to the service line. Strong serve there. Fator picks it up. Bagley with the high swing, and she'll get the kill. Point, Panthers. Williams now back at the service line for Boulder. Deep serve. Jones to Vanilis to Koopman, and that's over the block. She'll get the kill. Roar Kasi subbing in for Jones. Koopman will take a seat as Elder serves for the Lambkins. Deep serve. Boyle will pass it up to Chow. Out to Bagley. Bagley is blocked. Again, Boyle to Chow. Bagley with the tip. This time Vanilis picks it up. Roar trying to send it over into free ball will be sent back to them. Vanilis back to Roar Kasi. And it's kept alive. Bouncing off the basket. And the Panthers won't be able to send that one back over. Again, outstanding defensive plays, both sides of the court. These rallies are taking a while, and it's fun volleyball to watch. Elder sending that one out of bounds. Lodgeco back in for the Panthers. Chow will serve. Zerbowski with the swing, and it looks like no touch is called. That ball's out of bounds. Chow trying to get the lead back for the Panthers. They trail by one, 15-14. Bogusser to Vandalis. Roar with the swing, just sent back over. And that ball is out of bounds. We're high up here. It's hard to tell. Plus, we got that big student section in front of us. Ball's out of bounds. Panthers get the point, and it is all tied now here in Fort Collins. Chow sends that one straight into the middle of the net. Lambkins with the point. Boyer back in the game, and Roar will serve. Back to Cutter. With the swing is Bagley. Picked up by Roar Kossi. Deep swing by Zerbowski. Swing here by Lodgeco, and she'll get the kill. Bagley serving. That's one of the best contacts we've seen all night from Zerbowski, the freshman, finding her groove here in the fourth set. And right as she gets that kill, she'll take a seat. Geffra will serve. Cutter to Chow. Chow will give the ball back to Bagley. Tipped over, picked up by Roar. It's a tight ball. Roar Kossi up at the joust. She's going to do it again, and she's going to win it. Geffro continuing to serve. Sending that one deep, and it's in. Cutter to Chow. Cutter will send a free ball. Excuse me, Bagley. Stepped in there. Bogusser with the tip right to Bagley. Chow back to Bagley. Geffro will send it to Roar. Roar back to Roar Kossi. And that ball's out of bounds. Point Panthers. Fator serving for the Panthers. That one drops short, handled by Elder. Roar will give it to Bogusser, trying with a cut shot, but Cutter picks it up. Chow to Bagley. Roar with the pass. Bogusser is going to swing on two. Bagley is everywhere right now. That ball is out of bounds. Cutter can't get the touch off the block. Roar Kossi will take a seat. Jones will rotate in to serve. Jones with the cross-court serve, and it's out of bounds. Boyle coming in for the Panthers. She will serve. Geffer to Roar. Bogusser, and that one's out of bounds. We are getting close here to the end of the fourth set, all tied up, 19-19. Geffro to Roar. She'll give it back to Boyer. Boyer's blocked, but covers herself. And up at the net is Cutter. Rudiger calls a timeout for the Lambkins as they now fall 1 point behind here in the fourth. We'll be right back on Stream It Sports. Back here in the fourth set at Fort Collins High School. Panthers have recently gained the lead over the Lambkins. Getting towards the end here, Vogaser will take a swing, no touch. That ball is out of bounds and the Panthers are now up by two. Vandalis will sub in for Boyer. Rohr will take a step back. Vandalis will run this offense. Deep serve from Boyer. And she gets the ace off of Jones. With that, Jones gets to take a seat. Elder into the game. Boyle continuing to serve for the Panthers, up by three. Geffro with a high pass. Bogusser will send it high as well. Elder gets it over. Boyle to Chow. Bagley will take a swing, and that ball's out of bounds. Vandalis serving for the Lambkins, down by two. Let me remind you, if the Lambkins win, this match is over. On the other hand, if the Panthers pull it off, we're going to a fifth set. Cutter with a swing, and that's out of bounds. But it looks like Rohr is called in the net. Not a lot of movement on that net. Calling a tight game here. And with that net call, Rudiger will call a timeout. His second and final timeout of the set. We will be right back on Stream It Sports.
Wayne, everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
Welcome back to Fort Collins, Colorado. We are getting towards the very end of the fourth set. Panthers lead by three. That ball sent deep. Elder to Vandalis. Bogusser with the tip shot. Rohr, and that ball lands. It looked very in from up here, but the line judge calls it out of bounds. And we are now at set point for the Panthers. Geffro to Vandalis. Bogusser with the swing off the top of the block. Cutter passes it to Chow, out to Bagley. And that ball's out of bounds. Serbowski back in the front row for the Lambkins as Bogusser is back to serve. Needs to go on a three-point run to stay in this set. And that's not going to do it. Into the middle of the net. Panthers win the fourth set. We are now tied 2-2 going into a fifth set here in Fort Collins, Colorado. I'll remind you of the scores we have going into the fifth set. Panthers won the first 25-14. Lambkins came back to take the second and third set, 25-23, 25-18. Lambkins led for most of that fourth set, And then the Panthers fought their way back to win it 25-21. This fifth set will be 215 points, and we will bring that to you when we return on Stream It Sports.
Everyone complains about millennials. Nonsense. Millennials, I salute you. You save money like no other generation. You share cars, Wi-Fi passwords, canoes, deodorants. My grandson bought a pair of pants with me. They share pants. Today's his pants day. No baby boomer ever shared a pair of pants with me.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy.
An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore, you're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
Welcome back to Fort Collins, Colorado for the fifth and final set of our match here tonight between the Fort Collins Lambkins and the Boulder Panthers. We would one more time like to thank our banner sponsor, GoJo Sports. GoJo Sports has been providing team sport needs since 1974. Screen printing, embroidery, letter jackets, and more. Your local place to get high school gear. Check out their new location at 1437 Riverside, just down from the Colorado on the south side of the street. And while I was thinking GoJo Sports, we have our first ace of the fifth set from the senior setter, Chow. Bogusser to Roar. Boyer breaking through the block. Haven't said Boyer's name too much tonight. She's been pretty quiet, but when she does get the ball or the opportunity to get a block, she is doing her job very nicely. Geffro serving for the Lambkins. Cutter with the pass. Bagley will swing, and that ball's out of bounds. Geffer at the service line. Cutter passing again. Chow sending it back to Bagley. Bogusser with the diving save, and she'll send a free ball back to the Panthers. Chow wants to use Bagley again. That one, deep ball. Geffro picks it up easy. Roar back to Roar Kasi. She tips it to the middle. Picked up by Fator. Bagley with another swing. Geffro bouncing off the headboard. We're good. Vogeser sends it to the bottom of the net. Again, hard angle to hit, but just got to get that ball in the court after a long rally. Bagley serving for the Panthers. Geffro passing to Roar. Back to Roar Kasi. Chow picks it up. Bagley will run it down. Sent over by Fator. Elder up to Roar. Roar Kasi with the swing and the kill. Roar Kasi getting quite a few swings in tonight, but none quite like that. A swing meant for the highlight reel. Jones back to serve as Roar Kasi and Elder take a seat on the bench. Koopman up in the front row. Chow sends it out to Cutter. Off the top. Geffro will get it to Roar. Vogeser with the swing, and that ball is just long. Fator back to serve for the Panthers. We're all tied up early here in the fifth set, 3-3. Vogeser will pass. Roar gives it to Koopman. Koopman's blocked. Williams put some big hands up there at the net. Fator serving again for Boulder. Jones with the pass. Roar out to Vogeser. And that ball's long. Fator continuing to serve, now up by 2, 5-3. Vogeser with a pass, Roar will give it back to her. Off-speed shot, trying to find her rhythm again. Ball goes out to Cutter. Nice pickup by Roar. Free ball will be sent over by Jones. Williams with the swing. Roar trying to fight that one back. Nice hustle from Geffro, but just cannot get it. Williams with the kill. Now at a three-point deficit, Coach Jared Rudiger will call his first time out of the fifth set. We will be right back to bring the end of this exciting match on Stream It Sports.
Wayne? Everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
Back here at Fort Collins High School, we are ready to bring you the end of the Fort Collins Lambkins Boulder Panthers match here in Northern Colorado. Right now, the Lambkins are trailing by 3 after a back and forth beginning of this final set. Leah Fator back to serve for the Panthers. Geffro to Roar. Koopman will swing and she'll get the kill. No one up on that. Wide open net. The Lambkins passing has definitely improved against a very tough serving Panthers team, giving the Lambkins the opportunity to run the middle blockers a little bit more later on in this match. Van List serving. Williams with the swing. And it's bouncing back, but it's going to be called out of bounds. Rudiger will have his floor captain, Vogeser, talk to the up ref about the call. Yeah. It is most likely called out of bounds because the trajectory of the ball was going into the stands before the bounce off of the backboard of the basketball hoops. Boyle serving. Geffra will pass to Van Liss. Bogusser with the swing and the kill off the top of the block. And we have a double sub here. Looks like Whitcomb will come in to serve for Vogeser. Geffro will take a seat as Zerbowski enters the game. Whitcomb has got at least one ace every time she stepped back to the service line tonight. We'll see if she can do it again for the Lambkins. That one to Bagley. Nice pass to Chow. Williams with the swing. Picked up by Van Liss. Jones sets it back to Zerbowski, picked up by Bagley. Van Liss out to Zerbowski again. Roll shot off the top of the block, and she'll get the kill. The freshman shaking her head, as she's done previously tonight, not knowing how she got the kill, but can't complain at this point in the match. A kill is a kill. Whitcomb serving again. That one going deep. Fator passing it. And a block for Koopman and Roar. The classic "you got swatted" cheer coming from the student section. For those of you that are not familiar, swatted is more of a basketball term, but you can't blame them for trying. Roar will take a swing right over the block, and that one will drop. Point Lambkins, and the Lambkins now have taken the lead by one. And with that change on the leaderboard, Coach Radigan will call a timeout here in the fifth set. We will bring you the remainder of this set when we get back on Stream It Sports.
Everyone complains about millennials. Nonsense. Millennials, I salute you. You save money like no other generation. You share cars, Wi-Fi passwords, canoes, deodorants. My grandson bought a pair of pants with me. They share pants. Today's his pants day. No baby boomer ever shared a pair of pants with me.
Welcome back to Fort Collins High School, home of the Lambkins. They're hosting the Panthers and are deep into the fifth set of this match this evening. Whitcomb back serving for the Lambkins. Cutter's going to take a swing, but get blocked by Koopman. Koopman making her presence known in this fifth set. That's two blocks in a row for the senior. Whitcomb with another serve. Fator to Chow. Chow sends it over. Jones is ready. Van Liss back to Roar. That ball is in. Whitcomb plays it. Roar is going to take a standing down ball swing, and that one goes out of bounds. Very nice run for the Lambkins. Still up by one, but a crucial side out for the Panthers. Whitcomb didn't tally her typical ace there as she came into the match, but did a very nice job at the service line and on defense. Bogusser back in the game. She'll pass up to Van Liss. A heavy swing by Zerbowski, defended by the Panthers. Another heavy swing coming from the other side of the net. Bagley will get the kill. And again, we are all tied up here in the fifth set at Fort Collins High School. Vogeser will pass. Jones sends it outside to Zerbowski. Touched. A little bit of a scramble play there by the Panthers. Koopman will pass it. Vanderlis sends it out to Zerbansky. She gets blocked. It's kept alive, but we can't quite get it back over the net on the side of the Lambkins. Point Panthers, and the Panthers will now take the lead back from the Lambkins. Cutter continuing to serve for Boulder High School. Jones with the pass. Roar to Koopman. Dug up by Boyle. Jones to Roar. Out to Serbanski. Over the top of the block. Right up from Cutter. Hustle from Chow. Free ball sent over. Out to Serbanski again. Off the top of the block. Ran down by Bagley. Sent right back over. Dump from Roar. Kept alive. Bagley taking another swing. Vogeser up to Roar. Out to Serbanski. Roll shot over the block, and that'll land. Smart swing from the freshman. Lots of big attacks taken during that rally. A little change of pace caught the Panthers on their heels. And yet again, we are all tied up in the fifth set, 10-10, getting down to the wire. Elder serves. Chow will send it out to Bagley. Bagley's blocked. Massive hands up in the front row from the junior, Roar Haase. Shuts down the junior on the other side of the net, Bagley. Elder with another deep serve. Cutter to Chow, out to Bagley again. Bagley with the tip, picked up by Vanderlis. Roar sends it outside, and that ball is just out of bounds off the hands of Zerbowski. Lots of back and forth here as we're getting down to crunch time in the fifth set. Williams serving for the Panthers. Vogeser to Roar. Roar will run it down. And she's called under the net. Rudiger checking if he has a timeout left. Not going to use it for the time being. Williams will continue serving. Vogeser with the pass, and she gets aced. That is an ace for Nicole Williams, the junior middle blocker. After that, Rudiger will take his second timeout of the fifth set. We will go ahead and take one more break here and be right back on Stream It Sports.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy.
An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore, you're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
Back here in Northern Colorado in the gym of the Fort Collins Lambkins in the fifth and final set here. Panthers leading 13-11. It is time for the Lambkins to make their comeback if they're going to make one. Roar Haase with the swing and the kill. Vanderlis will go ahead and take a seat as Boyer enters the game. Roar serving. Cutter with the pass. Chow sends it up to the middle of the court. Picked up by Roar. Free ball sent by Roar Haase. Chow sends it over. Picked up by Elder. Roar wants to send it right back. Boyle's there. Bagley will send that one into the net. And yet again, we are all tied up here in the fifth set. Another timeout being taken by Coach Radigan. We'll go ahead and stay right here. Lots of back and forth going on. It's expected, just like the fourth quarter of a football game. These coaches aren't letting up. Again, we're only playing a 15, a couple points left here. These coaches have to figure out exactly what they're going to need to do to win this set. It's anyone's game right now, really. Again, the attacking has picked up on both sides. The defense has picked up on both sides. This match is going back and forth because these girls are playing to their fullest potential. We have a lot of juniors and seniors on the right side of your screen, but all the freshmen all the way up to the seniors on the left side of your screen are doing their job. Some fun volleyball here in Fort Collins, Colorado on this fine Tuesday evening. And we are back at it with Rohr serving, sending it deep. Fator passes it up. Chow runs it down. Cutter will send the free ball. Elder to Rohr. Rohr saves it almost, and she's called in the net. It's one you got to shake your head at on a free ball. Elder knows. She wants to be able to handle that one. Great composure right now from the Panthers. Their leading setter, Chow, back to serve for set and match point. Elder to Rohr. Rohr gives it to Rohr Kossi. She'll tip it over, picked up by Fator. Chow goes out to Bagley, and that ball lands in the court. With that, the Boulder Panthers will win here in Fort Collins tonight in five sets. Very close game, 25-14, 25-23, 25-18, 25-21 in this final set taken by the Panthers, 15-13. From Fort Collins, Colorado, I'm Samantha Peters on Stream It Sports, bringing you this match with my help from Chris Colton. We will see you later.
Poudre School District High School Volleyball, live on Stream It Sports, has been brought to you by Schrader Oil. Fuel your day. By Pedersen Toyota, everything car is made easy. And by First Bank. Visit any of our convenient locations in Northern Colorado.